Karamoja is home to over 50 types of minerals endowed with large scales of gold, marble, iron ore, copper gemstones and graphite, but with the highest poverty levels. Simon Peter Nangiro, the chairperson of Karamoja Miners Association, says the minerals which the region received as a blessing are turning into a curse since they have been left behind as spectators in the business with no direct benefits.
Really, Karamojongs are still in a state of shock. Because they hear, yes, it is wealth. But what wealth? When people are living very desperately like that, we just see loads of trucks leaving, even beginning to spoil our good roads, with excess loads of marble and limestone. And then the players themselves are not friendly to us, the companies that have come to extract these minerals. A case in point is where the security is guarding places and keeping away our population.
During a consultative meeting between members of parliament from Karamoja and the Parliamentary Committee on Natural Resources, organized by Resource Rights Africa and Advocates for Natural Resources and Development, about the Mining and Minerals Amendment Bill of 2021, MPs from Karamoja called for an affirmative action in the bill to ensure that mineral hosting areas receive better percentage of royalties from proceeds of the minerals.
It's not really clear how much do we get as the local people in terms of local revenue in the mining sector, because everything is not yet clear. So that's why we need to make sure that we amend this law, and this law should protect us with the local people, including other Ugandans. We need it to be like other laws, so that by the time when the mining sector reaches at a point of satiety or the bliss point, we shall have already benefited at least in terms of education, in terms of road network, in terms of health sector.
The issues of royalties, how we share resources. Good enough, there is the petroleum law, which provides for royalties. But this time round, government must be able to compel these investors to pay royalties. And we will think, we really pray, that the best entry point to the operation of this land is that the Ministry of Lands must come to Karamoja quickly, sensitize people and provide communal land titles.
They also called for protection from notorious miners by providing reforms in the licensing policies, compel mining companies to pay royalties arrears, and also restore the degraded environment. MPs are concerned that the ministry in charge of minerals has been issuing mining licenses and surface rights on people's land without their consent.
The process of licensing has been a very difficult thing. We hear a license has been given in Kampala over somebody's land, and you, the owner, is not even aware. These people, the people who get licenses, deal with the technical people in the ministry, in the surveys here. They deal with the chief administrative officers, who are civil servants.
Speculators, people who come, take over the land, and then they survey the land without the consent of the local people. These are speculators. And because they know that tomorrow there will be companies coming for mining, and they should compensate them. So there are so many gaps that we need to address in this bill.
Concentrating and being excited by extracting resources and forget to concentrate on other areas. And also our inability to build capacity to understand these things. And they're not new. Because in Karamoja, you can walk on the streets and find, especially the ladies, because they do much of the mining work.
The Minister of State for Mineral Development, Peter Lokeris, has assured the public that the bill is the solution to all bottlenecks affecting the growth of the mining sector.
The new act which we want, there are some omissions that we want to introduce. There are some mineral commodities which are not included. There are some people who should be participants who are not completely given enough space to do their participation.
The bill aims at providing a transparent and sustainable marketing strategy for minerals by setting up buying and auctioning centers for minerals. This will address speculation and also provide security to mineral dealers.
There is a need to provide for setting up of a mineral buying strong auctioning centers to market the minerals for competitive prices and also promote government involvement. Now catered for in the new bill.
The government also seeks to create a fund where mining companies shall be required to deposit part of their income to restore environment degraded by mining activities.
We have not yet got the amount. We are discussing. Now we are going to parliament. They can decide to put a percentage or through what we call the subsidies legislation. The regulation can insert it there. So that there is some money all the time saved by a company A, which is operating point B.
Despite the huge economic potential, the mining sector contributes less than 0.6% to the GDP because it's over-dominated by artisanal miners, which the bill seeks to turn around.